Hello guys, welcome to us with Simplejay. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to trade futures and everything about futures. Welcome back guys, and welcome to us with Simplejay. In today's video, like I said, I'm going to be showing you guys what futures trading actually means and how you can start trading futures. In the previous time, you definitely know that I really don't like trading futures, and in fact, since the past few days, and many people have been asking me, those that have been seeing my status on WhatsApp, some of my students and some people who have been some of my members who have been seeing me making profit from futures, my status has been asking when I started trading futures and why I so much love futures. Well, right now I had to do my own research and found out what works for me on futures, and I've been profiting from that on a daily basis. But please stay tuned to the end of this video, because there's something I want to do. I want to show you guys, I want to tell you guys about scalping of future. So stay tuned to the end of this video. I won't take much of your time. But don't waste too much of your time. Let's just get down to business, all right? So what is futures trading? Like you can see on my screen, it's very, very simple. Futures trading, a future contract is an agreement to buy or sell an asset at a future date or an agreed upon price. You know, the same way we buy coin, maybe on Binance or anywhere. You know, when you buy coin, definitely you can't buy coin out and sell a day before. Definitely you buy the coin and what you sell what at a later date, the later date and agreed upon time, or maybe a future date can be the next minute, the next seconds, the next hour. All right, as far as it is future, it is not something of the past. Okay, you can't buy a coin today and sell it yesterday. No, you have to buy it the other day. Okay, the next you have to buy now then sell later, all right? So, but when it comes to futures, you are actually trying to buy a coin with money that does not belong to you. You are leveraging upon someone else's money, all right? Don't worry about all these jargons I'm saying. I will break it down to you, for you. And at the end of the video, you will get to understand everything about futures. Maybe things you've not watched before, what people have not maybe told you before, you will learn it in this video. So, in futures trading, we have what we call leverage, all right? Yeah, you need leverage to trade futures, because that is why futures is much more profitable than spot trading, all right? Unlike spot trading, you just go to Binance, you place a trade for a coin. After buying the coin, you hold the coin, all right? Then when the price of the coin appreciates, you just sell it and you make your money, right? Now, if you buy a coin with $100 on spot trading, maybe you just buy a Cardano token right now. Maybe you buy Cardano token of $100 worth of Cardano token. Maybe after buying Cardano token, Cardano move by 30%. That means your $100 will turn to $130, which is you make 30% of money. But if you trade that same Cardano on futures, all right, and you use the power of leverage to trade that same Cardano, if you make 30% of that Cardano on futures, instead of you making $130, all right, you can make about $300, right? You can make about $300. You can make about 300 at 30%. You can make about $300 depending on the leverage you use. Like I said, don't mind the jargons I'm saying. As we continue, you will understand. So, what is leverage, right? Leverage is the ability to control a large contract value with a relatively small amount of capital. In the futures market, that capital is called performance bond or initial margin. And mind you, don't forget that in futures, it's just like more or less like you are predicting if a price of a coin will either goes up or come down. Why? Because you can either make money, you can either profit when a price of an asset, maybe a price of Cardano is coming down, is dipping, you can make money on it with future. Or you can either make money when the price of an asset, e.g. Cardano or even BNB or Bitcoin, is going up or coming down. Unlike spot trading, you can't make money when the price of a coin is coming down. When you are trading spot, maybe you just buy a coin and you hold. You just have to hope and watch that the coin keeps on appreciating, because that is the only way you can make money. So if the price of the condenser after you bought $100 worth of your token of Cardano or BNB, then the price of in sports trading and the price of it starts coming down, maybe market start dipping, you start to lose your money on spot, right? Because the coin will lose value, but the unit of the coin will remain. Let's say you buy $100 worth of Cardano, maybe you buy $100 worth of Cardano and you were only able to buy 50 units of that Cardano, and the price of Cardano starts coming down, you won't lose that 50 units of the Cardano, right? But the Cardano will lose value. It's no longer the 50 unit of the Cardano will no longer worth $100 again. Maybe if it has come down to -20, that means your money will now be worth $80. All right. Unlike futures, when the price of Cardano is coming down, you can profit from it. And if the price is also going up, you can profit from it. All right. But I will explain everything to you in this video, right? So this is what leverage means. But like I said, forget these jargons. The next video, the next thing I'm going to show you now, we explain what all this means. And at the end of it, you will come to realize futures. So let's go there. Now, let's say you have a home. You want to buy a home. You want to buy a house. Like me, for instance, I love houses. I love it. And you want to buy a house, and the house cost about $100,000. Sorry for the mistake. $100,000, all right? You want to buy it, but you don't have $100,000 with you. Okay? So, saw a home you like, and you want to buy it, and they tell you that the home cost about $100,000, right? So what will you do? You head straight to the bank, and you go and meet the bank manager that, see, I want to buy a house, my dream home, and the house cost about $100,000. Now, in this case, our bank is our exchange, right? Maybe Binance or any other exchanges that trade futures, right? In this case, again, the home we are talking about represents what? Any cryptocurrency, maybe Cardano or maybe anything, all right? Now, when you are going to the bank to buy, when you go to the bank, you went to go and meet the bank manager that, see, I want to buy a house. It costs about $100,000, but I don't have the $100,000. When you get to the bank, please, I need this house. Then the bank tells you, okay, fine. You need this house. You said yes. Then the bank said, okay, fine. We will help you get this house for $100,000. But before we help you get this house, but you must make a deposit, or maybe because you want to go and collect a loan. Then the bank tell you, okay, fine. For us to give you this $100,000, for people to acquire this $100,000 for the home, you need to make maybe a advance payment, or maybe collateral. You need to leave a collateral of about maybe 10%, or 20% of this $100,000. You need to drop it first to the bank. Be sure that you are really ready. Should in case if you're able to buy these houses and anything goes wrong, we know that, okay, we still have some money with us, because they want to see how serious you are, right? You can't just go to the bank, $100,000 worth of house and $100,000 worth of house, and you don't even have any dollars at hand. It's not possible. They won't give you. You are not serious, because anyone could walk to a bank, all right, and say, I need money to buy a house. But what differentiates you people is what you have. Okay, what do you have to stand to prove how serious you are that you really want to buy this $100,000 worth of house? Okay, so the bank say, okay, fine, for us to buy this thing for you, you have to drop 20% of the $100,000 for us. Drop it with us so that we'll know how serious you are. Fine, then you have an agreement with the bank, but the bank will give a condition. When they give you that $100,000, you have to make sure that these houses, you know, houses do appreciate, that nothing happens to the $100, because for $100,000, when they give you the $100,000 to buy it, they won't even give you, let's say they want to buy it on your behalf, they'll just give you the house. Now you head to the bank, then you give the bank the $20,000, which is what 100% of what which is 20% of $100,000. Give the bank your $20,000. Okay, fine, I'm serious. Take this $20,000, because that is all you have, and you want to buy a house worth $100,000, but you add $20,000 with you, and you give to the bank. The bank owe the $20,000. So now, after you bought these houses, bank now give you an house worth what, $100,000. Maybe they give you the $100,000, but the $100,000 won't come directly to you. That is, maybe the bank helps you. You contacted the owner, the person that want to sell the house, then the bank paid on your behalf. All right. However, the bank still have access to this house, because definitely they borrowed you, $100,000, you only made an advance deposit of maybe $20,000 to the bank to show how serious you are. All right, that means you are still in the bank about $80,000. They're just helping you get your dream houses. So what's gonna happen now after you bought this house? You know, you drop $20,000, 20% of the $100,000 that the house cost. Now you bought the house, all right, you're flexing the house. Maybe after buying the house, the house started appreciating. Maybe the way you take care of the houses, fire did not burn it, kept on planning different things. You use it for, maybe you use the house for business. You modify the house to some kind of taste that it's now attracting investors. Maybe they see the house, they saw what the house has become, and people now like the house and they want to buy it again, and the house now appreciates. Let's say after buying the house, after a year, the house appreciates by what? And all right, after some times, the house appreciates by 50%. Now 50% of that $100,000 worth of house is what? Is now what? $150,000. Okay, 50% of it is now what? $150,000, because the house has appreciated. Okay, you bought it $100,000, the bank able to get the house at $100,000. Remember, your $20,000 is still with the bank, they are holding it. Now the house started appreciating, all right. The $100,000 worth of house is now worth what? $150,000. Now you have the right to sell the house, right? Because it belongs to you. Now, what is going to happen if you decide to sell that house immediately? And you'll be fine. People have started pricing this house, and this house is now costly, it has appreciated. And you sell this house now. Remember, this house signifies the any cryptocurrency you want to sell, okay? And the bank signifies maybe Binance Exchange, all right. Now, if you sell this house right now, all right, at what? 5:1, all right? Because 5:1 means you've made 50% of it, of the initial money the bank gave you to buy the house. Now, if you sell this house at $150,000, you now have what? $50,000 profit. After selling it, the money that goes to you is the $50,000. Right, the $100,000, remember, it is not your what own. The $100,000 does what? Goes back to the bank. Then the $20,000 you gave to the bank will release it to you. That is what the touch entails. I'll still dive down further so that you can understand more. All right, now the bank helped you to buy your dream house of $100,000, but because you were so good, all right, in real estate, I'm using real estate to explain. In real estate, you develop the house, it could be land, then the house is now worth about $150,000. And I say, okay, fine, I want to cash in on this house. Now the house increased by 50%, all right, and you did what? After the house has increased by 50%, the $100,000 worth of house is now worth $150,000. Then you decide to sell it. After you sold that house, you gave back the bank the $100,000, because they will even immediately you sell the house. All right, the bank controls everything. Automatically, the $100,000 will go to the bank. $50,000, what? Will go to you. That means you've made $50,000 profit, and the $20,000 you gave to the bank to hold as collateral will be returned back to you. That means you've made $50,000. Wow! By leveraging, by using the power of leveraging, by using money that does not belong to you, money that belongs to the bank. But before the bank gave you money, they wanted to know how serious you are, and they asked you to drop 20% of that money, which you did. All right, now you might be wondering, what is then so dropping the 20%? What if when you buy this house, the value reduces? What is going to happen? This is what's going to happen. That is where the $20,000 the bank collected from you comes in place. Now, let's say after the bank collected this $20,000 from you to hold as collateral, then they help you to buy your dream houses. Don't think the house belongs to you yet. The house does not belong to you yet until you're able to pay the $400,000 back. Now, let's say after you bought this house, okay, you got this house. Then the price, something happened to this house. So remember that the bank is holding your $20,000. Now, after you bought this house of $100,000, the bank helped you to buy it. They are holding your $20,000. Now, this house got burned. Maybe something happened to it, or maybe due to your carelessness, you were very, very careless. Then fire burned this house. Then the value of this house kept on going down. Now, from the $100,000, the value of this house has gone down to 90,000, that is what? Minus what? 10% because of the value of the 100,000. Now remember, the minus 10% means the $20,000 the bank is holding on your behalf means $10,000 has gone out of the what? Money. Because when you lose, immediately the value of this asset, immediately this asset lose value, any percentage it loses is affecting your money with the bank. This value loses asset by 10%, your money, your $20,000 loses value, and will reduce by 10%. Now, if this value, if the value of this house reduces again by under 10%, which means you've lost $10,000, which equals to what? $20,000. Remember, you gave this bank, you gave bank $20,000 to hold. What's going to happen? That means if as the value of this house has reduced, what's going to happen? What's going to happen is the $20,000 that is with the bank automatically is gone, and the bank will immediately automatically take back their house. What is going to happen? That means you've lost your $20,000 and you've lost the house. The house is no longer yours. Automatically, bank will collect the house from you and sell it. Why? Because the house value is now worth $80,000. And your $20,000 is still with the bank, which means the bank doesn't want to lose their money. So bank will quickly sell the house automatically for $80,000. Then they will add the $80,000 with the $20,000 you deposited with them, making $100,000, meaning they've not lost anything. You are the one that lose. Now, let's say why the value of this house is going down. It has gone down to minus 15%, which means the house is now currently worth $85,000. And the house just is just have just five, you have 5% left for you to lose your money with the bank. You have 5% left. This house must not lose 5% value anymore. And let's say you are not skeptical, you are scared. What's going to happen to hold this house to for this house to remain being yours? Because automatically with the bank, your money with the bank is left with $5,000 because this house has lost 15%. What you have to do is either you rush down and go and look for money to quickly come to give to bank to hold again. It's that you quickly go and look for under 15%, $15,000, and quickly give it to the bank that take so that the bank will add it with the 5%, with the $5,000 with them to make it up back to $20,000 because you've already lost $15,000 from it. Grab. But if you can't do that and you can't lose another 5%, meaning the house is now worth $80, the bank will automatically sell the house. Automatically, they will sell it. Will sell it, and they will send a letter to you that, sorry, the money you were holding for you is now so small. The money we're holding for you, the house we bought for you has depreciated by what? By 20%. And the 20% is worth $20,000, which is with us, which automatically means you don't have any money with us anymore. So this house no longer belongs to you. You have to back out of the house. That is what it means. That is what is happening in futures too. Now, let's say when the price of the coin depreciated by 15%, all right, the value is now worth 85%. You are now good at building the house back again. Then you decided to build the house. And while you kept on building the house, the house started what? Appreciating again. Then the more the house appreciate, the more your money with the bank. Let's say your money with the bank was left, you left it when the house was worth $85,000. Your money with the bank is now left it worth $5,000, and the house now appreciate again by 15% again. That means your money with the bank automatically goes backwards towards $20. As long as your money is still with the bank and the asset holding is not losing value, you keep on making more money. All right, so that is it. Now let's say you did not borrow money from the bank. You decided to use your 20%. You said you don't want to borrow money from the bank, that I will go with your $20,000 to go and buy a small house, a mini studio, just a small house, which means you are not borrowing money from the bank, you are not borrowing money from anybody. You just want to use the $20,000 to buy the house you see. Then you buy the house. That is 1:1. Meaning you are using your $20,000 on like 5:1, in the sense that bank give you 5 times of your house, of the money of the house you have, 5 times of your current worth that you wanted to use to buy the house. That is 5:1. Now in this case, in this 1:1, it means you are using your money, you are not borrowing from the bank, you are not borrowing from anyone, you own the house automatically. Now if you buy this house with your $20,000 and the value of the house you bought increased by 50%, So $10,000 will be worth for $30,000. That means you will only make profit of what? $10,000. Now, can you see the difference between leverage and just buying up by without leverage? When you use leverage, you make more money in profit. But at the same time, if the value of the asset reduces, you make more loss when you use leverage. But if you do not use leverage and just decide to buy directly, what will happen? You will make small profit. But when the price of your asset falls by 20%, you only lose small money, because if you lose 20, if this price of this small studio you buy, this house you buy just goes down by maybe, let's say the house just goes down by maybe 20%. That means you will only lose 20% of 20,000. You only lose $2,000 compared to what you would have lose. All right. If you had used leverage. So that is what leverage is. All right. So let me use crypto as an example for you. Now let's apply it to cryptocurrency. All right. Now let's say you have $1,000 with you and you want to invest in ADA, Cardano, you know, Cardano token. You have $1,000, but you want to buy Cardano token of worth $100,000. But you only have $1,000. You want to make more money. Now, you can either do two things. If you want to make money with buying Cardano, you can either go and buy with spot. Spot trading means you go ahead and buy $1,000 worth of Cardano. All right? Just go ahead, buy $1,000 worth of Cardano, and you hold it. Now, buy $1,000 worth of Cardano. If Cardano increased by 30% or 50%, that means you are going to make about, what are they calling it? If Cardano increased by 30%, that means you are going to make $1,300, right? If you invest $1,000. And if Cardano comes down by 30%, that means you are going to lose what? $300, meaning your money is going to be left with what? $700 if you invest $1,000 in Cardano. Now, but you want to buy $100,000 worth of Cardano and you just have $1,000 with you. So what's going to happen? That's where features comes in. You use the power of what? Leverage. Mind you, the $100,000 the bank borrowed you here is called what? 5x, because they borrowed you 5 times of your money. That is what? 5x. 5 times of your money means 5x. And represents 5x, all right? So now, what's going to happen? You're looking fine. I want to buy 100,000 worth of Cardano, but I only have $1,000. You go straight to Binance, tell Binance, Binance, I want to buy $100,000 worth of Cardano, but I only have $1,000. And Binance will ask, okay, what do you have? I'm just saying, but Binance won't ask you that question like that, but that is what feature means. Then you extra to futures on Binance, it is okay, fine. Also, it'll allow you to buy 100,000 worth of Cardano. Say you want to buy 100,000 worth of Cardano, then feature Binance say, how much do you have? Then $1,000. Okay, fine. Binance, okay, fine. You can. That means we have to give you times 100 of your money, right? Binance, we have to give you times 100 of your money for you to be able to what? Buy 100,000 worth of Cardano. We have to double your money 100 times for you to be able to buy 100,000 worth of Cardano. So now, Cardano is called ADA. Now, you went to Binance, you said, okay, fine. What's the price of Cardano? The price of Cardano at that time, let's say the price was 1.3130 at that very time. That was the price of Cardano. Now, Binance is holding your money. That $1,000 signifies what? What are they calling it? That means you're giving Binance the $1,000 to hold, to show your seriousness. All right? Show your seriousness. You're giving Binance $1,000 to hold it for you as collateral. You're giving them collateral of $1,000. Okay, take. Borrow me $100,000. Then Binance borrows you $100,000, but they are holding your $1,000 as collateral. Show how serious you are. All right? As collateral. They're holding your $1,000. They've given you $100,000. You won't get the $100,000 as cash. So what is going to happen is, while you're trying to buy this USDT ADA token, because you needed $100,000, then that was what's going to happen. That means you have $1,000, that means they have to give you 100x of your what, $1,000. So while trying to buy this other Cardano, you will see an option called leverage. I'll be showing you on Binance soon. We see an option to choose the amount of leverage depending on the amount Binance can borrow you for that particular asset, Cardano. Every asset has Cardano. It's just like when you go to the bank and you want to buy a house, there might be the maximum amount bank can borrow you for house, and that might be different for what they will borrow you for a plane if you want to buy a plane. All right, so now let's say Binance can borrow you up to 100,000, up to 10x of that your money, and you went there, Binance borrow you 100x. So while you are trying to buy this Cardano, you will have to choose what, 100x. That means you are telling Binance to multiply, to give you Cardano what, 100 times of what you are giving to Binance to hold for you, 100 times of this 1,000. You know, we choose it and Binance will check your balance to see how much is there. You have $1,000. How much are you demanding for? 100x. Binance will give you Cardano token worth 100x of your balance in your futures, because what, you've choose 100x that Binance should give you 100x of the money. You want to buy 100x of the money. You want to borrow 100,000 from Binance, which is 100,000. All right, because since 100,000 divided by 1,000 is cost to 100, that means you are using a leverage of 100:1, meaning you are using 100x, meaning with your $100,000, you'll be able to buy up to $100,000 worth of Cardano. So once you choose it, the Binance will know, okay, fine, 100x. They're telling us that we should borrow you what, $1,000. You are telling us that we should borrow you $100,000. That is times 100 of your $1,000. So Binance will give you the token. Binance will give it to you, right? You will not buy it. Remember, this is future. If it was spot, you won't be able to buy up to, you only be able to buy 100,000, because that is what you have. You have $1,000. So it's $1,000 worth of token you will buy. But because you are using the power of leverage, you are telling Binance that borrow me $100,000, hold my $1,000 as collateral, then Binance will give you $100,000 worth of Cardano, because you choose 100x. Now, after you bought it, you bought Cardano. Remember, you bought Cardano when the price was 1.3130. After buying it, the price of Cardano, all right, moves to 1.3140. Now that ADA has moved from 1.313, because 1.3130, we can still call it 1.313 because you bought it at 1.313, then the price of ADA moved from 1.313 to 1.314. That is 10 pip. And that 10 pip from there, it's moving what, 0.1%. That means Cardano just moved up by 0.1%. Now, because you are now in 0.1% profit, you close your trade. You close your trade at when ADA is at 1.314, which is 0.1%. It means you will make profit of what, $100, because you use a leverage of what, 100x. That is 0.1% of the $100 which Binance borrowed you. You make what, $100 profit, just a 0.1% movement. Why? Because Binance borrowed you $100,000. All right, but let's say you didn't use leverage, you just went to go and trade spot and you buy $1,000 worth of ADA at that same price, 1.313. All right, spot trading, your profit will only be $1, because 0.1% of $1,000 is what, it's $1. So at 0.1% of the $1,000 worth of ADA, if ADA move up by 0.1%, you will only make $1. But if you're using leverage of 100x, you make $100. Can you see the difference of somebody trading spot and somebody trading futures? What if you bought the same token at the same price range, but because one already borrowed a loan from Binance, he borrowed a loan of up to $100,000. He borrowed a loan of up to $100,000. What is gonna happen? He's in more profit than you. But be careful. Be careful. Have to be careful. The same way you may be profit is the same way you can lose big money. Now, let's say after you buy the ADA, you requested for $100,000 worth of loan from Binance, and Binance give it to you, right? So after buying it, you you buy it, and after giving you, the price of the ADA now falls to 1.312 from 1.313. That's minus 0.1%. If you close your trade 10, you will lose $100 of your initial $1,000 with Binance. If you continue losing and your loss is now 1%, let's if you lose 1%, and that keeps on going down, after you bought, keep on going down, up to the point that you've lost 1%, which 1% of the 100,000 you were borrowed, which is what, $1,000, automatically, Binance will close position for you, meaning they will close the trade for you automatically. That means your $1,000 is gone. What I say, your $1,000 is gone because the loan you gave to Binance are holding, you've lost it when they gave you the money. So what they are saying, that this person is not serious. It's not serious. We gave him $100,000 and they are holding your $1,000. So if you keep on losing the money, you keep on acquiring loss, and the loss got to $1,000 that you gave to Binance. Binance will tell you that, this guy is not serious. They will quickly close position so that they don't lose their own money, because they borrow you $100,000. You deliberately owed the collateral of $1,000 to see how serious you are. But when they see that you kept on losing and you've lost $1,000, they will quickly close the position just to make sure they don't lose their own $100,000 they give to you. But let's say after you've lost about $900, you've lost about 0.9%, and the price keeps on going back up again, then your money keep on increasing again. The $100 left with Binance, because you've lost 0.9%, let's say you've made profit of 0.1% more, that means $100 will be added back to the balance with Binance. So your money keep on increasing again. But now, let's say you did not use leverage, yeah, and just decided to buy $1,000 worth of ADA, maybe sports trading, that's sports. And after buying, the price of ADA falls to minus 0.1%, it depreciated by 0.1%, you will only lose $1 because you did not borrow money from anyone, you only use your $1,000. Can't see the difference between the two. That is the power of what? Leverage, right? So that is the power of leverage. That is everything you need to know about futures. So you've been hearing futures. This is what futures really means. And I believe you've learned one or two things from this video. But now, the next thing now is I want to show you something on Binance page. Right, on Binance page. So I want to show you how it actually looks like on Binance page. And I want to explain, because there are two types of futures trading. We have the isolated and we have cross. Right, I want to tell you the difference between the two. Okay, so I want to tell you the difference between the two. So I'll be switching to my phone right now, and where I'm currently trading future live. You will see me trading. I'm in profit already, but maybe before I show you, I might be in loss, but I don't think so. That's great, because as I said, stay tuned to the end of this video. I've been scalping cryptocurrency using futures on trading. All right, so I want to show you the interface of my phone right now, and I believe you now understand what futures is. If you don't understand, go back and watch this video, you will understand. It's just like you borrowing money, but for you to borrow money, you submit a collateral, and in as much you do not, the loss you've acquired in court is not up to the collateral you gave out, you will still be in trade. But if it's up to, they will close position for you, they will close the trade for you, and you've lost that 1,000, you've lost that collateral. All right, so let me switch to my phone. So guys, I'm back to my my Binance app right here, and later you can see it, and this is how Binance interface looks like. And if you want to trade futures, and what you just have to do is you will see something down here called futures. That is where you have to trade futures. But if you go to futures the very first time, what is going to happen is you can see that I'm in profit. I'm currently trading a coin right here with just small money. Actually, I was in $50 profit before, but it comes down, you start see coming down, going up, but I've mastered this trade and I'm making money. And if you want to know, you can check my Telegram channel. Check below this video description, you see a link to my Telegram channel where I showed people how I've been making money with trade. I think one of these days I will do a live trading section with you all, where I will trade scalping futures, and you see the money I will make in your eyes. I can't deceive you. Definitely, I'm not deceiving you, and I'm sure many of you that have been watching this video, you've been seeing my status. Many of you on my WhatsApp, you've been seeing my status of I make money with futures, because I'm currently doing 30 days challenge on our futures. I'm about to start it though. Futures VIP group, scalping VIP group. So I will talk more on that at the end of this video. So stay tuned. So let me explain how this thing is. So this is the futures interface. Once you click here, you see futures. But if you click on trade, that's where you can what buy maybe spot or all these things. This is where you can buy spot trade. This is where you can buy anything like anything that has to do with sports trade. This is where you can do it. But for me, I'm falling in love with futures now. So because it helps me to make more money. So now what you want to do here is this. Once you come here, right, this is how it will look like. So now I want to do an explanation of what I explained to you. Now let's say I have $100. All right, I have $100, and I want to buy CLR. CLR represents, what are they calling it? CLR represents the house. Let's just say the house. I have $100, right? But I want to buy $2,000 worth of CLR token. How much do I have? Just $100, but I want to buy $2,000 worth of SLR. So I went to Binance Futures right here. So what I'm gonna do is just come to this up here. Which asset do you want to buy? I will choose CLR because you have many tokens right here. Many you can search for, but me, I want to buy CLR. Okay. And what do you want to use to buy? Because on Futures we use USDT to trade. USDT is the dollar version of the crypto dollar version of the fiat currency. Even while I'm trading this, when I'm in minus, I'm not really scared because of the strategy I use in scalping futures. I'm not really scared. I would have take profit since maybe before the end of this video, you might see me in $30 profit. I would have take profit since even if I was in minus before, but I'm in plus. I was even in plus $50 before. You will see it. I don't need to deceive you. I make sure I do live video. You see me currently trading. All right. So I don't just enter trade blindly. Do my analysis right before I trade and before I give people that. Quickly buy this coin. Now what you have to do is, now I've chosen my coin, which is the asset I want to buy, a coin CLR, just the same way I explained that to you. I want to buy what I have $100, but maybe I want to buy, I'm telling Binance that please help me, I want to buy $2,000 worth of this thing, but I only have $100. Binance Martin, how much do you have? I said okay, fine, I have $100 with me. Binance, okay, fine, no problem. Now no problem. So there it is. This is buy, this is sell. Don't forget, I told you that in futures we can buy and sell. We can buy in the sense that if I click on buy, that means I'm telling Binance that see, I want to buy Susu coin, and when I buy this coin will appreciate. When I buy the coin and Binance has given me the loan, you know, maybe I have $100, I want to buy $2,000 worth of Cardano of this CLR. It's Binance finances for me, and I'm able to buy what of this coin. This coin must continue to go up for me to profit because I click on buy. So we call it long. When you hear the word long also means buy. We mean we are predicting the value of an asset, that when we buy that asset, it will go up. We are telling bank that this thing will go up. I'm telling Binance that borrow me money to buy this thing because this thing will go up. Fine, Binance will give me, but I must give them what, a collateral. How much collateral they want to give Binance? Well, I said I have collateral of $100. That is the amount that I have. And Binance said, how much do you want? I said I want $2,000 worth, because I want to buy $20,000 worth and $2,000 worth of this coin. And I said, okay, fine, no problem, we give you. But one thing must not happen. One thing must not happen to this coin. When you finally buy this coin must not lose value. If this price of this coin keep on going down, the $100 I gave to Binance will start the dot. And if let's say that is the only money I have in my account and it finish deducting and I'm at -$100 after Binance has given me the money, I will lose my position. Binance will automatically end this trade for me, meaning I've lost my $100 because Binance won't want to lose their own $1,900. They won't want to lose it. So Binance will what? Binance will close the position. Can see that the thing is going down, but I'm not afraid. Because I bought this thing with maybe $100. I gave them $100. They're looking at it. We see it in minus. My seat in minus. When you see it in minus, you see that you see it in minus now. I'm praying to go to minus so that I will explain something to you. My seat is still in minus. Binance, if this thing goes to minus, Binance will end this trade for me. But Binance might still not end this trade for me. And I will explain this why Binance might not end this trade for me. That's where this thing comes in place. So if you want to play this kind of trade, all you just have to use, just like the way you trade, limit order. Limit orders means you want to buy this coin at a particular price. You don't just want to buy at market price. Maybe this coin is currently at 1 point. You know, this coin is currently at 1.568. You can see the current price there, 1.5668. So if you want to limit this order, the same way we buy on Binance, it means we want to buy this coin at what? We want to buy this coin maybe when it comes down to maybe 1.5, maybe 1.5100, maybe 1.5100. Right, so if I place trade for this coin here, right, you know, I've choose buy, place it for this thing here, then you have to choose this thing here, either cross or isolated. I will explain what these two things means. All right, now let me explain what these two things means before we proceed. But before I explain it, let me just show you something I'm talking about. So let's say you choose any of the two, one of these two here, right? Then Binance will now tell you, okay, how much you want us to borrow you, right? This is where you choose your leverage. This is the leverage. You now say, okay, what? See, you can see that the only leverage Binance can give me here is up to 50x. I can only borrow up to 50x from Binance for this particular asset. See, only up to 50x, right? Now, this means, how much do you want us to borrow you? I tell Binance that, okay, I want you to borrow me 50x. If I drag this thing right here, that means I'm telling Binance, borrow me 50 times of what I have in my balance. So for me, instance, if it is $100, I want to give Binance as collateral. I'm telling Binance, borrow me 50 times of this, my money. That means Binance will borrow me for my $100 I'm giving to Binance. If I choose 50x, that means Binance will be giving me what? $5,000 worth of CELR. However, if the price of this coin keeps on going down and it gets to minus $100, Binance will end this trade automatically. And Binance might not end this trade. And I will tell you the reason why. Now, once you choose it, 20 times you want Binance to borrow you 20x of your money, you borrow you. You now come to this place, the right amount. Oh yeah, how much you want to buy? This is where you now decide the amount you want to buy. The amount in the sense that this, the amount you want to buy is means the amount of collateral you are giving to Binance. Because I've choose 20. Let's say I want to give Binance $100 collateral. So I will drag this thing here. You can see it. As you are dragging it, we see that it's showing what? $120 here, right? It will be showing it. How much do you want to give Binance? How much are you putting? If I drag it to 100, you can see 109. You can see it's 109, right? You can see 109. That means 109 is giving me 14,540 worth of CELR. That means 20x of my 109 is what? 20 times of my 109 is what? Is almost $2,090. So that means this coin I'm having here with me, $2,090 worth of what? $2,090 worth of coin. Let me copy it for you and see. Let's do the live practical. So now you can see it. Now I've dragged $100. That means once I play this trade, that means I'm giving Binance my $109 as collateral for them to hold. For them to, and now they've given me in return a token worth $2,090 worth of CELR. Now, if it keeps on going up, I make profit. And if I end the trade, the profit belongs to me, and Binance take their 2,090 back. Why they release my 109 for me back? However, if I'm minus, if after buying the coin, I'm losing, then the minus you keep on showing in my 100, this is my 100, this is my $109, you keep on reducing. If you keep on reducing, once you get to minus 109, the trade will end automatically because I don't longer have money to sustain the trade. Binance will close the trade. That is what we call liquidation. That means I have been liquidated, meaning I don't have money to keep that position again. I don't have any collateral with Binance again. I'm not good at what I do. And Binance don't want me to eat part of their money. So they quickly end the trade. That means I've lost my money. All right? Now, just to prove to you that this is actually worth 20 times of this, you can see that the cost of this is worth $109. And for $109 at the price, when CLR is at 0.1510, all right, that means 109 will give me times 10 of this, that is 109 times this 20, will give me this, that is $1,090, will give me 14,540. Let's go and see CLR in spot and see it. I've copied this thing. Let's go and see the amount what to give us in spot. Come to market. Search for CLR. Make sure you search for CLR/USDT because it's USDT we are using to trade. I see different peers, but see, USDT means the dollar one will be using. Let me click on buy. This is spot trade. You can see it's also the same limit, but only see buy. There's not like long. You can either buy here after you buy your token and sell back. But on futures, you can predict either the price of a coin is coming up or going down. Now, if I pay the same amount of CLR that they gave me for what? Can you see what I'm talking to you about? 1,4,5,40 in spot with what? But $281,000. That is, let me calculate for you. 109 times 20. Can you see it? 109 times 20 is also 2,180. Right? 2,180. The reason why it's giving me this price is because CLR is currently at 156. You know, I told you that if let's say this thing comes to 151. Let's see. Let me paste it for you so that you can see it. What is this? 2,195 at 0.151. And you see what I'm telling you? This is what it will take you to buy this thing in spot. But now, because we are using futures, Binance is giving us this thing. Binance is giving us this thing for 109. They are giving us 109. Can you see the cost of it? Cost 109 because what? Binance has automatically giving us 20 times of this money. They are borrowing us 20 times of this, our money. And that's what we are buying. So at the same time, I can also sell. When I say sell, that means I can also buy the same amount of coin. If it comes here, I can also buy it. What's going to happen is if I buy this this coin at 0.150, oh, this thing, if I drag it and buy 100 and maybe 100, okay, $113 worth of this coin, Binance will give me what? At this price, Binance will give me what? 31,015. So Binance will help me to multiply my money and give and help me to buy this coin. But what's going to happen if I because sales is also known as short? What's going to happen if I buy this thing at this price? If I choose sell and I choose 20x and I click on this thing, what's going to happen is once I buy, if the price of this coin gets to 0.1510, Binance will automatically help me to buy this thing. Once they buy it, it means I will only profit from this trade if the price of this thing keep on going down. But if the price of this thing gets to here and Binance help me to buy it and the price now start going up, I'm in debt too. This my 112 starts reducing. That's what we call short and long. Long means you are buying an asset of its price, predicting that the price will keep on going up, and you can only make money when the price of the asset keep on going on up. But if you short, it means you want to buy this asset at the same time, and you are predicting that after you bought this asset, this thing will continue going down, and you only profit when the asset of the thing go down. So if you go and short any coin, any price you buy, if you short it at 1510, you only make money if the price of this thing keep on going, and maybe like 1510, 14 something, 0.150, 0.140, 0.130. If it's continue going down, you're making money. But if from 150, 151, you bought this coin, it kept on going up, and it goes back up to 0.157, you are losing. And if the total loss you've incurred is up to the amount you use in buying it, let's say you buy it to $112 or $113, Binance will automatically close the trade for you, meaning you've lost that $112. But like I said, Binance might also not close the trade, and that's where this cross and isolated takes place. Now, if you are using a cross, you switch to cross. If you choose cross before you choose your leverage, cross means Binance won't consider this amount of money you're using buying it, but rather they will be considering the money you have in your available balance. So when you are using cross, you can use a leverage that is big, meaning you can see that the reason why I'm able to make money where I'm not scared. The reason why I'm not scared with this trade I'm currently open on is because why? I'm using cross. All right, cross has advantage and disadvantage. What cross does is when I buy maybe $100 worth of this coin, you know, remember I bought $100 worth of it. I bought $106 worth of this 106, and I choose 28. That Binance should borrow me 20 times of this $100. I need the coin. I want to buy 20 times of my $100, $106 of this CLR. And they say, okay, fine, we'll give you the money, and they help me to. They give me the worth of that coin. So now, even if this coin keeps on going down instead of it to go up, you know, market price is the, this is current market price, entry price is the price I bought the coin. Now, after I bought the coin, you can see that I bought the coin at 0. I placed a limit order at 0.15608, and the coin came down to 0.15608, and it helped me to buy 106 based on margin. Now, I was telling you, margin is just like your collateral, the collateral you are giving to Binance. Okay, that okay, this is what I need to, this is what I have. Okay, fine. This is the multiple of what I want you to give to me, and they hold it for you, right? So when it goes here, even if I'm in minus, Binance will close this trade. You know why? Because I am used cross. Because Binance will no longer consider this margin anymore, this collateral, but rather Binance will focus more on what is on my what balance. That's my balance. My balance is worth $3,859, right? So that is the collateral balance Binance is holding as a cross. When you choose cross, it means Binance will only consider what is in your what available balance. So even if I'm in minus $100, I told Binance Binance to give me I said Binance should give me 20 times of my $106. Now let's say instead of the coin to continue going up, it continued coming down, and I'm already at minus $106. This trade will not close. Binance won't sell it. You know the reason why? Binance is just because I still have some money left. Let's say I'm banking with them, I have a lot of funds in their bank. So Binance said, okay, if my balance is still showing, I have enough money to cover up for that trade. You know, that means Binance will only deduct with the 106. Binance will only deduct it from this available balance. That is what Binance will do. They will only deduct it from this available balance. That is what they will do. They will continue deducting it. The more I continue getting minus, they will continue deducting it. They continue deducting it. But after they deducted everything, let's say I kept on continuing minus, and this one I get to maybe, you know, I'm currently 3.98. The more I make money, the more this thing keep on increasing. Now, let's say the thing kept on reading minus 100, minus $200. The trade is the CLR continue going down instead of going up because I long now. I long, telling them that to go up. It's not going down. And because I choose cross me, they will only be considering what is in my available balance. They won't consider the margin anymore. They won't consider the initial collateral I give to them. They will only be considering the money in my available balance. And they will help me to keep up with the trade. They will hold the position for me. They will hold the trade for me. Meaning, this thing will continue what? They will continue minusing my losses from this place, this available balance. Now, let's say they minus the loss, so, and the thing is now reading minus 300 something, minus 3009. They will quickly close this position automatically. Why? Because I don't have enough balance again in my what? In my cross balance. So let's say, I see that, hey, this thing is already at minus 350, minus $3,050. And I want to keep up with this position. I still believe that the price of it will still go up. So what do I have to do? I can quickly rush to my spot. All right? I can quickly rush to my spot account balance. If I have any money there, I quickly transfer it to my futures balance. Let's say I have another $1,000 there in my spot, and I transfer it back to my futures wallet balance. That way, I will now have $1,000 and maybe $40, which means I have enough money again to cover the trade, and balance continue eating from that one. But you can see that it is risky. It is cross is risky sometimes in the sense that if the market deep all of a sudden dip happen, like the one that happened earlier this year, and it didn't just happen all of a sudden unexpectedly, they will eat up all the money here. And let me tell you, when you buy a coin, you see your liquidation price. You can see my liquidation price will show. Liquidation price means the price this coin will fall to before you lose all the money in your balance, all the money here. Liquidation price means, if you're using cross, liquidation price means the price this coin must fall to. My liquidation price might be at, maybe if my liquidation price is set to 0.11, that means if CLR gets to 0.11, all the money here will be gone. That is what they call liquidation. All the money here will be gone if they say my liquidation price is there. But you can see that there's no liquidation price. Do you know why there's no liquidation price? Because the liquidation price is low, far, because Binance knows that it's impossible for the money to get to, for CELA to drop to that price. They not put liquidation price because the money I have in my balance is much, because I use 20x leverage, and I only tell Binance to borrow me I asked Binance to borrow me times 20 of my 106, which they borrowed me. So Binance realized that, I have a lot of money in my balance because I'm using cross. So that way Binance did not even bother to put liquidation price, because they know that that it's almost like impossible for the CLR to just drop. It's not like it's impossible, but they see that it will take it's kind of, you know, I don't know how to put it. It's not just easy like that for CLR to come to that price, because my liquidation price now to buy this thing is around maybe 0.00 something, all right? Because of the amount I have in my balance, I have enough money in my balance. So that suppressed my liquidation price. That's why I said I'm not scared. Even if this thing is at minus, I can go to my bed and sleep because I have a lot of money in my balance. I have a lot of money in my balance. So that is what it means. I have a lot of money in my balance, so I can go and sleep. Now, but I told you, if, like, say, while I'm sleeping, the price of this coin now keep on dipping, and it dip to 0.0.01, which is my liquidation price, all this money before I wake up will be gone. That's why cross is risky. So to avoid that, what you have to do is what? We come down, once you place your trade and the trade has hit, you see that there's what we call what? Stop profit and loss. What means is you can come here, you click on it, stop profit and loss, to set your stop profit and take profit. I can actually set my stop loss and take profit. So from here, you see TP signifies stop loss and take profit and loss, and stop SS signifies stop loss. So what I'm going to do here is this. Once you click on it, you will choose position. Position, if you click the position TPSL, it means this particular CLR you are trading, that particular CLR that you want to sell stop loss and take profit for it. But if you use this initial one, that means you want to set your stop loss and take profit for all the general position you'll be trading in the future. Meaning, let's say you combine what are they calling it? While you are trading CLR, you are trading another coin. I want to set all the stop loss for the two, but it does not make any sense, because just like you are setting a default stop loss and take profit for everything. So I like setting for position the current coin I'm trading, that specific coin I'm trading, that specific trade. Right, you click on it. Once you click on, let me cancel this one, because you can cancel your stop loss. Now you see the first step, take profit, stop loss, you can set the two. So they are telling, okay, when do you want to take profit? Me now, I want to take profit at maybe one. I want to take profit when CLR gets to 0.170, right? So if CLR moves to 0.170, I will make $188 profit. Imagine, I only spend $100, so because of Binance has borrowed me 20 times of my money. So this is what I will make if Binance, if this thing gets to like maybe 0.170, that means that's like almost 100%, or that is about 190% of my money, not even 100%, right? That's like times two of my money. That's like 100% of my money. That's the amount I will make, almost 100% of my money. All right, that's that moment. If CLR just moved to 0.17 now, while I'm trading, I've made more than $88, and I do this thing every day. I'm currently doing a challenge, 30 days trading challenge, where we want to be making, want to make $3,000 within 30 days on futures. Today we have it, we have how we do it. At the end of the day, we go down to our adjust and write down the amount we make trading futures. And that's what we do. So we want to be making $100 profit per day. As I'm speaking with you, before I did this, I made profit. Again, I'm still waiting. If these things couldn't get to this, my take profit, then if it gets to $50, I end the trade. I will repeat it again, at least for 24 hours. If I'm able to make $100, I'm not trading futures again for that day. That's what we are doing. So if you want to join our group where we are doing this, it's $70 per month. Which means pay $70 per month, and we are doing a trading a 30 days trading challenge of $30,000. There's no way, even if you can't smash that $3,000 $100 per day, but we will smash more than $1,000, which means at the end of 30 days we have money to again subscribe. All right, so that's what we're currently doing, and so far so good. With those have started, we made money. We just started it too, but we've made our 170 something. We've made about 170 something, because per day sometimes we might make more than that. For instance, now I set my take profit to 1.70. If this price gets to this price, that means what I've made, what, $188, which is even more than the amount you set for per day and daily target. So that is just one thing about futures. All right, so once you set it, you can set your stop loss at how much you want to lose, because we are using cross, and cross is dangerous. So you might say, okay, how much do you want to lose from this money? If this money comes down, how much do you want to lose, so that Binance will quickly help you to end this trade, so that you won't lose much. If I say, okay, if this thing comes down to 0.155, that means I will lose what, $14 out of my money, out of the money in my balance, out of my $3,000 plus, I will only lose $14. if I set it like this, I will lose $14 of this money, right? Once I'm done, once I have set it, I'll just click confirm. But let me just show you what would happen. I'll put my own to 145. If I set to 145, that means I will lose 150 of this money. If the price falls to 145, all right, then you click on confirm. Now that I've said this, check here, they've helped me to set it, take profit. I'm taking profit at 1.70. If this price of this coin moves to 1.7, I've made $188 profit. If it falls to 0.145, I've lost what? $150. They will remove the $150. They will remove it out of the money in my balance. Why? Because I'm using cross. All right? Because I'm using cross. Okay? That is what's going to happen. That is it. But for me, because you're always scalping, I don't like using take stop loss because of the strategy I'm using. You can actually go back there. If you want to go back to your stop loss, just click on this icon here, or click on this place, whichever one. But this one will take you directly. Once I click on the icon here, it takes me to my position, and I can cancel my what? This, I can click on cancel to cancel my stop loss if you want to set a new one. I don't like using stop loss when I'm scalping. I have my own reasons, okay? I don't, because of the strategy, and you can see that since we've been trading this thing has gone to minus since I've been talking to you. That's why I have a strategy I'm using, so I make profit. I profit from it. So that's why I don't use stop loss, because I just want to make more money for this trade. If I make up to $50, because if not because of this video, I've already made $50 before, but I just want you guys to see it before it drop. It's still going there. So once you get there, I end this trade. That means I've made $50. I'll wait again and enter again for good entry point again. I make another $50, then I'm done for that day. Maybe for this particular one, the challenge I'm doing, all right. But for me, personal trading, I know how much I'm making. You can see the upper position, which I close, I hide it here for you, all right. So that's me for you. So now let me explain isolated for you. Now, if it is isolated means want to restrict Binance to the amount they can charge on your account, all right? The margin, which means click confirm. They won't allow me because I'm already trading cross. You see here, I'm trading it on cross, so they won't allow me. Let me just quickly choose another token to explain to you guys. Just choose ADA, the ADA I was talking about. This is ADA. Okay, so this is ADA now, all right? So from this ADA right now, so let me just choose isolated, right? I'll show you what's going to happen. You know, I've not done analysis. I'm just using this as a video, so I'll just buy small. Now, let me just show you something. Now, let's say I want to predict that will go up. I want to predict that it will go up. Let me just read that will come down. Okay. Now, say like that, I want to short. Short means I'm predicting that will go down, right? So what's going to happen? And I place a limit order, I'll buy at market price. We have market price. Market price means if you want to buy market price means the current price of this coin is where you want to buy. Once you choose market price, there won't be need to put any price there. Just have to track this thing to the amount of money you want to give to Binance. You want Binance to double for you. So for this, because of this video, I will just use maybe 3x leverage. Just want to use 3x. You can switch it 3. That means I want Binance to borrow me times 3 of any amount I put in this place. Any amount that I'm showing in this cost is what I want Binance to borrow me. They will give me the amount of that token in ADA. So if I now switch, let's say I want, because for the sake of this video, I'll just use $10 because I have not done my analysis. I want to long because you see, ADA is going down, ADA is going up. I want to long, but I will set the limit order. Let me just set markets. I don't want to waste much of our time again. Now, so what I want to do is, now I've choose 3x leverage, this isolated, 3x leverage, and I choose isolated. Isolated means I want to restrict them to any amount I give them is any amount I give them. If I choose $10, the only amount I can lose is $10. So let me quickly buy ADA. Let me buy that word. $10. $10. I will buy it immediately at market price. I will take confirm buy. Now I bought at that, right? So if you scroll down here, you can see Ada here. It's only Ada that I'll be showing. Now see something from here. Market price, which price did I buy Ada? Entry price 2.1504. Where is Ada now? Ada has dropped down to 1.4 something now. You can see I'm a minus, right? Right, I'm a minus. How much Ada did I bought? I bought Ada of $12.19. That's what I give them. This is isolated. Now what this means is, if this minus that is showing here, all right, if this minus that is showing here gets to minus 12.9, automatically I will lose the money here, right? And this trade will be closed. Binance will close this trade for me. Automatically, Binance will close it for me. Do you know why? They won't touch this balance here. The reason why they will close it is because they won't touch this balance here. They won't touch, because I choose isolated. Isolated means I'm restricting Binance to only choose the money in my margin. So Binance won't touch the money in my future balance. No, because I've already choose isolated. Isolated means I'm telling Binance that the only money they should remove is this one. The one here. That is what isolated means. They will only remove this money here. So that way, even if I did not set my stop loss and I went to go and sleep because the money I put there is small, if Binance chop it, if the thing gets to minus 12.9, they will close the position for me. Then you have lose the 12 something dollars. But at the same time, you have to set your stop loss and take profit, because you want to take profit. You have to set it through the same way I told you. We see stop profit and loss. You click on it again. Is this the same thing? You go to the same position, take profit. Where do you want to take profit? Maybe if Ada gets to let's say I say if Ada gets to 2.2. If Ada gets 2.2, how much will I make? I will make $0.8 profit if Ada gets to 0.2.2. Then if Ada gets to, then from here, stop profit and loss. Way down to stop my losses. I can simply 2.145. So at 2.145, if Ada falls down to 2.145, I will only lose $0.09 out of my money, right? Only lose what? And then you not click on confirm, but I will not stop it. I will only lose $0.21 if it comes to 2.145. I only lose $0.02 of this money here. And let's say the thing is now coming down to minus, this thing is now showing minus $7. This money will keep on reducing. We start seeing your money here will be reducing. It's the one year you see minus $7, then the money you have left here won't be more than $5.19. So now to keep this trade, so that Binance does not close this trade, what are you gonna do? You have to click on this plus. Once you click on it, they will tell you to adjust your margin. That is the collateral you are giving Binance. Adjust it. It means top it up. You can top it up with extra money. Let me top it up for you. We see it. Let me see if they show me my liquidation. And I want to show you something. Yeah, you can see the question I'm telling you about. You can see liquidation here, and you can see my risk. Liquidation here is showing 1.44246. What is happening? What happens is, if the price of Ada falls towards 1.44246, automatically lose all the money here. That is what this thing is telling me. So you cannot decide if you want to use cross or you want to use isolated. So if the price of Ada comes here, as long as the price of Ada does not come to 1.44246, I will not lose all the money here. I will still maintain this position. I will maintain this trade. Either it goes up or comes, I will still maintain it. But immediately the price of Ada falls to 1.44244, I've lost this trade automatically. This trade will close. I've lost this money here. So what are you gonna do? Let's say the price of this thing is now coming to, the price of Ada has gotten to 1.4. All right, and I'm already at minus $10. And I want to keep this trade. What do I have to do? I have to quickly click on this plus, which is margin. I will top it up, just like you're topping up your margin. What is gonna happen? Watch something. They will increase my liquidation. Remember that my liquidation is 1.44247. Be looking at what happened. If I top this thing up with another 12 points, $12, you see that they will increase the liquidity. Put your eye here. Let me top it up with another 12.5. Can you see that they've reduced my liquidation? So now what you have to do to sustain this thing with cross, what you just have to be doing is you have to be continuing adding more margin, more, like I explained to you, that you are giving Binance more collateral, you are increasing your collateral. You are giving them more collateral. That's what it can happen. You are giving Binance more collateral. All right. You are giving them more collateral. That's what's going to happen. So as soon as I give them more collateral, we see that your liquidation will be reduced. Now if I click on confirm, now you see that my risk has reduced to 0.96, because either we have to go to 0.70, all right, 0.70 before I lose all these $24. Consider my money is not in $4. So in cross trade, in isolated trading, is only the margin balance that will be touched. They won't touch your future balance, no. But if you're using cross, they will be eating out of your what? Just they'll be eating out of your futures balance. That is where it's strictly. But if it is margin, they won't eat it. It will only be add to maintain the trade, just be topping your margin up from your futures balance up manually. You only be doing it manually. Right, you only be doing it manually, and the more you are doing it, they'll be reducing this thing. Assuming I use cross to buy this same amount of ADA, we see that my liquidation will be at 0.0. It will not even show liquidation price. You know why? Because I have more than enough balance over there. I have more than enough balance in my cross, more than enough balance, more than enough. That's just it. All right, I have more than enough. Now, let's say you're already in profit. Let's say you're already in profit. You can decide to close this position. Let's say I'm in loss or you're in profit. Whichever one you are, you can close this position. Like, let's say you don't want to trade again. Just click on close position. You want to sell. Immediately you close position, it will help you to sell at market price. You can either choose whether they should help you to sell at market price, but it's always good to leave it at market price. Immediately you click on close position, you confirm. Click on confirm sell. They will help you to close the position and sell it. They'll sell it for you. All right, they've sell it for you. You sell it for you. So now let me buy the same amount of ADA, $12 worth of ADA. I will buy $12 worth of ADA, but using cross. Right, you will see the difference now. You will see that they might not show liquidation. Now let me use cross, because I already closed the other trade, so they will allow me to use cross this time around. Now I want to buy at 3x again. I want to buy $12 worth of ADA. Now $12 worth of ADA at market price. I don't want to wait for limit or that, so I want to buy at market price. But only, you can only set limits. You set the price. If the price falls to that price, it should help you to buy. Let me buy at market price. Now I bought $12 worth of ADA. Let's see. I'm profiting immediately. You can see I'm profiting. I've made 0.43% profit. You can see liquidation price. Can you see that there's no liquidation price? Why? Because I have enough balance in my future balance. So the liquidation might be 0.0001, 0.00. Let's say that Cardano goes back to 0.00001. It's not possible. That's why they did not set liquidation. As long as I maintain that balance in my futures wallet, I can leave this ADA like this. Eh? Maybe at this also price, this $12. I can leave it. I can even leave it for less. I can leave it for till December without setting stop loss and only set take profit. You know why? Because my liquidation is far. The balance I have in my futures wallet is much. You will see, let's say now, if I leave it, click on this, take profit. Let me see the amount I will make if ADA gets to, let's say tomorrow ADA gets to $50. Maybe ADA is heading the Solana way. Let's say I leave it to, I did not touch it December. And before December, because I have enough balance in my wallet, and ADA now gets to $50, that means I'll make $949 profit. $949 profit with just $12.19. And why? The only time I can do that is because my liquidation is far. So ADA cannot just come down to it. You can see I'm already in 0.11 profit, almost 1% profit. You can see. But it's because I put small money. Assuming I put in $200, you can tell. If it gets to 1%, 1% of $200 is what? It's $2. I would have made $2. So 1% would have given me $2. All right. So that's how it works. So if you want to close the trade, let me just close it. Just close this trade. If you want to close in profit, just close automatic. And so if you want to close trade, you can choose to close 50%. If you want to close 50% of the trade, you click on it. If I click confirm, it only confirm sell. It only helps me to close the 50% of this trade. Oh, Okay. I hide this thing. That's helping me to close 50%, but because I hide other peers, so it has hide it. So that is how trading works. All right. That's once that is all you have to know about futures, both cross and isolated. That is the difference. Cross, they eat from your main balance. Isolated, you restrict them to eat from certain balance. All right. So that is how trading works. So my next video, I'm going to show you guys how to, because before you start futures trading, future first ask you question. They you have to watch a video. You have to do some tests and you must pass the test. So I will give you the answers to those questions. All right. In my next videos, I will give you the answers to those questions. All right. So after I've given you answers to those questions, and you will feel it, and I will now show you how to transfer money from your spot wallet to your futures wallet. All right, so that you can get started. And by that, you can then start scalping features with me if you want to join. Check the below this video description, or check the number on your the Telegram ID on your screen, or check the this particular video description. You see a link to contact me on Telegram. It's just monthly $70, right? Small, and they are doing 30 days challenge, 3,000. The challenge will continue till December. So that's what we're gonna be doing now. So you can see now that by now I'm profiting from ADA. From the, you can see I bought ADA at 2.147, and that's already at 2.1533. So I already made profit from ADA. So with my scalping strategy, we will be making money on a daily basis, guaranteed money, $100 per day. So guys, if you have any question, leave a comment in this video description, and if you don't, you can contact me on what are they calling it, Telegram. All right, I'll be waiting. If you want to join our premium group, you can contact me. All right, so if you want to join our scalping channel, you want to join us in scalping, making money, so you can contact me on Telegram. All right, so thanks for watching, and do have a wonderful day ahead.